Now let's say you wanted to search for some text inside of TextEdit. Easy enough. You can choose Edit and then Find or use Command F and search for the text. And it will find it for you in the text. And you can use these little arrows here to jump to each one and hit Done to exit. But suppose you wanted to find something more complex. There's actually a way in TextEdit to find some complex data. It's called Insert Pattern. It's part of the Find function. So I'm going to do Command F for Find and I'm going to clear it out. And then I'm going to use this little magnifying glass here and you can see I have some options like ignore case, wrap around during my search, that kind of thing. Starts with, full word, all sorts of stuff. Now there's also something called Insert Pattern. Let's select that and we get this second menu here. And we can see that there's a whole bunch of special stuff in here. At the bottom there's some very special things like finding an email address. Let's select that. And we can see that it found one. You see the little one here. And there's the email address in the text. We can also try to find some of those other things. Notice Insert Pattern has Control Option Command P as a shortcut. So we'll use that from now on. It's a lot easier selecting this. We can choose URL and we'll find the one URL here. I'll clear that out and I'll do that keyboard shortcut Control Option Command P and let's choose phone number and it's going to find two phone numbers. There's the first one and there's the second one and you can see they're even slightly different in their formatting. So it's kind of interesting to be able to use these to quickly find these things. How else would you be able to search for them in TextEdit since you don't know what the phone number or what the email address is? But there's some other stuff inside of Insert Pattern that allows you to do even more complex searches and even replacements. Let's say, for instance, you wanted to find two words but they weren't next to each other. There's going to be a word in between them. So let's just take these words here in the first and the last one. So I'm going to do a find here and I'm going to search for that first word. And then I'm going to search for something in the middle. So it's space and then I'm going to use Insert Pattern and say any word. And you can see it inserts a little thing there. It says word. Then I'm going to do another space and another word. And now it's going to find 12 instances where it will find any word that's these three words even if the middle word is something different. So let's change this to something else. And find, and we'll see it found it here and then found it here even though the middle word is different because we're using this kind of wild card for a word there in the middle. Now let's say you wanted to search and replace with a tricky replace here. For instance, you've got a list here of states and their capitals and the date they became a state. It's perfect except you want it to be the state name first and then the abbreviation. So we can use Find and Replace to fix this. So first thing we'll do is we'll find a special pattern for a word. Then we'll do a special pattern for tab. So any word and then the tab. And then we'll do special pattern again. And instead of word we'll say any characters. The reason we don't say word is because we know some states have two words like New Jersey for instance. Now we'll look for a tab again. And we can see here it's still capturing a bunch of odd things. So let's at the beginning say, well, let's have this all start with a line break. So it only happens after the start of a new line. So now we could see it found 49 of them and we can go through them and we could see here we've got all of them except the first one because of course the first one doesn't start with a line break. So we'll insert a line there temporarily and we'll search here again. And now we see it found 50 of them. Great. So let's check replace here and then let's work on a replacement for this. So what we'll do is we'll say, well, let's first start with the line break again. Okay. Now we'll go and we want to put the second thing first. So we'll do the selection from here. See, notice below this line it's all the things that we're finding. So we can select any of these. And we can reverse the order. So it's going to find a line break, a word, a tab, any set of characters, and then a line break or a tab. And then it's going to put them back but swapping out the any set of characters in the word. And I hit replace all and you can see it did exactly that. It's got the state abbreviation now after the state name. So it does what we want. And notice if you have more than one thing, like say we were to do any set of characters. Let's undo this and let's say any characters for the next set and do a tab again. And then to complete it, we'll take the date there. We'll do any characters and then we will do a line break. And then we'll get rid of this one here at the beginning because we don't need it anymore if we're going to search the entire line. Now we notice it can find 49 of them. It can't find the last one because there's no line break at the end. So add a line break at the end there. And we could see that it found 50 of them and we can go through them. And notice that if there's word and then any one, any two, and any three. So we can now insert any three tab, any two, and then line break. So now we could see that we're basically reversing the first two. Word, any one and word, and then any two, any three, and any three, any two. So it's going to reverse the state abbreviation with the state name, and then it's going to reverse the capital with the date. I'll replace all, and there we go. It does it. So you can do really complex things. It doesn't have to be an entire line like that. It can be some sort of complex format codes or things like that. And you can use this in TextEdit to do some really interesting complex searches and replacements.